Hey, this video was made just for you. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
The next thing we will learn is positive, negative, and zero work. Think before you answer. Discuss the directions of force and of displacement in each of the following cases. So let us talk about each of these cases and let us see the directions of force and displacement. Pushing a stalled vehicle. A stalled vehicle is a vehicle at rest, that is a vehicle that is present in one place. So this is a vehicle that is present in one place and we are pushing it. So when you push it, the force is also in this direction and the displacement will also be in the same direction as the force applied. The next example, catching the ball which your friend has thrown towards you. Now here the ball is coming in this direction and when you catch it, you stop it. So we have to put a force in the opposite direction. So here the force and displacement are in opposite directions. Tying a stone to one end of a string and swinging it around and round by other end of the string. So here there is a stone which is attached to a string and we are swinging it round and round. So now when you move it around this direction, the force applied would be towards this direction of the string and its displacement would be in the round direction. Walking up and down a staircase or climbing a tree. So here when you climb a tree, the displacement is in the upwards direction. But when you push against the tree, that is the force that you apply. So here the displacement and the force is in a perpendicular direction. Stopping a moving car by applying brakes. So here the car is moving in the forward direction. And when you apply brakes, the force applied by the brakes on the pedals are in the downward direction. So here also the force applied and the displacement is in a perpendicular direction. You will notice that in some of the above examples, the direction of force and displacement are the same, whereas in other cases, these directions are opposite to each other, while in some cases, they are perpendicular to each other. So, in these cases, the work done by force is as follows. So, this is the conclusion that we have derived from the above examples. When the force and displacement are in the same direction, that time theta is equal to 0 degrees. Because when both the force and the displacement are in the same direction, the angle difference is 0 degrees. Therefore, the work done by force will be a positive number. When the force and the displacement are in the opposite direction, then theta would be equal to 180 degrees. So here when you see, when force is in one direction and displacement is in the other direction, theta would be 180 degrees. Then the work done by the force is negative. When the applied force does not cause any displacement, or when the force and the displacement are perpendicular to each other, then theta is equal to 90. So sometimes there is no displacement, like how we seen in this example of the stone being turned around in the direction of the string, in the round and round direction. So here the stone comes again back to its original position. So there is no displacement, whereas the force has a direction. Or else sometimes how we seen in these examples where we were climbing a tree or when there were brakes applied, here the theta is 90 degrees. So in this case, the work done is zero. So we have three examples. One where theta is equal to zero, one where theta is equal to 180, and one when theta is equal to 90. So after finding cos and multiplying it with the force and displacement, we have certain derivatives. So if theta is equal to zero, work done is positive. If theta is equal to 180, work done is negative. And if theta is equal to 90, then the work done is 0.
Try this.
take a plastic cup and make a hole in the center of its bottom. So we take a plastic cup and using a needle or a sharp pen, we make a small hole in the middle of its bottom. Now we take a long thread, double it and pass it through the hole. So we take a long thread and double it so that to make sure that the thread is nice and thick. Otherwise, you can use a thick thread and not double it. Tie a thick enough knot at the end so that the knot will not pass through the hole, taking care that the two loose ends are below the bottom of the cup. So now after we pass the thread through the hole, we have to tie a knot so that when you pull on it, the thread will not pass through the hole. Tie a nut each to the two ends as shown in the figure. So we have to put one nut on this end of the string and another nut on the other end. Now do the following. So as shown in the figure A, put the cup on the table, keep one of the nuts in the cup and let the thread carrying the other nut hang down along the side of the table. What happens? So here as shown in the first example, that is figure A, we will take the cup and we will put one nut inside it and there is a string that is passing through the hole that we have made at the bottom of the cup, and on the other end of the string we have this other nut. Both these nuts are same. So when you do this, you will see that this nut just hangs down at the side of the table. Now as shown in the figure B, that is this figure, when the cup is sliding along the table, stop it by putting a ruler in its path. So when we put this nut which was hanging here, after a while you will notice that it is pulling this cup because this cup is made of plastic and it is not that heavy. And the hole that we have made is not thick enough so that the nut will pass through it. So because of the weight this nut puts on this cup, it will start sliding along the table. So when it is sliding, we have to put this ruler in the middle to obstruct its path. As shown in the figure C, that is the next figure, keep the cup at the center of the table and leave the two nuts hanging on opposite sides of the table. So now we will do another one in which we have one nut on this side and the other nut on the other side. So now we will notice that the cup does not move. So let us do these following questions. In figure A, why does the cup get pulled? So in this figure, we had the nuts hanging on the same side. So because of this, the weight on this side was more, and that is why it was causing this cup to slide along the table. In figure B, what is the relation between the displacement of the cup and the force applied through the ruler? So here, the ruler is putting the force on the string in this downward direction, and because of that, the cup is not able to move any further. So therefore, the displacement happens in and the force is in perpendicular directions. In figure C, why doesn't the cup get displaced? So here, there is equal force acting on both the sides of the string. And because of that, both of it cancels each other out, and what we are left is zero force that is acting on the cup. Therefore, the cup does not move either right or left. What is the type of work done in figures A, B and C? So let's see. In figure A, the force and displacement are in the same direction because the nut pulls the string and there is a downward force, like this force acting on the cup, and it also moves in the same direction. So here the work is said to be in a positive direction. In this figure B, the ruler is putting a force that is stopping the cup from moving. So therefore this is acting as a negative work. Whereas in figure C, even though there is force applied, but because it is in equal and opposite direction, it gets cancelled out and there is no work done on the cup because there is no displacement. As you remember, work is equal to force into displacement, and since displacement is zero, therefore work done is zero. So the first example tells us about positive work, second example tells us about negative work, and third example tells us about zero work.
Suppose an artificial satellite is moving around the Earth in a circular orbit. So what is an artificial satellite? These are certain machines that are sent by the Earth to revolve around the Earth in a circular orbit. An example of a natural satellite is the Moon. But artificial satellites are certain machines that are sent by the Earth to revolve around the Earth. So they have a certain circular orbit that they follow. But Earth has a gravitational force that acts on it. So why does these satellites don't get pulled towards the Earth and crash into the Earth? As the gravitational force acting on the satellite along the radius of the circle and its displacement along the tangent to the circle are perpendicular to each other, the work done by the gravitational force is zero. So now this is the Earth and let's say this is the satellite. So here there is a gravitational force acting in this direction and the displacement is along the tangent of the Earth of the orbit acting in this direction. So this makes the theta perpendicular, that is 90 degrees, and cos 90 is 0. Therefore, work done will also be 0. So there is no gravitational force acting. Even though there is actually a gravitational force acting, the work done by it would be zero. Institutes at work. The National Physical Laboratory in New Delhi was conceptualized in 1943. It functions under the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. It conducts basic research in various branches of physics and helps various industries and institutes engage in developmental work. So there is this National Physical Laboratory which is in New Delhi and it does various researches in physics so that we derive all these formulas. Its main objective is to establish national standards of various physical quantities. So national standards is like in the whole India, that is, there should be a proper standard of various physical quantities. It is not like in one part of India, they have a different formula for work and a different unit. Whereas in the other part of India, when calculating work, they use other formula. So this cannot be possible. Therefore, this National Physical Laboratory makes sure that there is a proper standard of physical quantities.
Now let us use whatever we have studied to solve certain examples. Example 1. Calculate the work done to take an object of mass 20 kgs to a height of 10 meters. So we have to find out what is the work done. And they have given us the mass of the object, that is 20 kgs. And we have to take that object to 10 meters of height, and what they have given us is the gravitational pull of the Earth, that is 9.8 meter per second square. So we write down whatever they have given to us and we find out the force first, because for using work we need force in the formula. So we need to find out the force, and the formula for force is mass into gravitational velocity. So they have given us the mass as 20 kgs and they have given us the gravitational pull, that is 9.8. But a very important thing is this negative sign. Why have they put this negative sign? Because we have to take the object from the ground level upwards towards the height of 10 meters. So this we are doing work against the force of gravity. Therefore we have to use this negative sign. The negative sign is taken because the displacement is opposite to the direction of the force, because the gravitational force is acting towards the ground and we are displacing the object opposite to that direction. Therefore, we have to use this negative sign. Therefore, when you multiply 20 with minus 9.8, you will get the force as minus 196 Newton, and Newton is the unit for force. Now we have the force, so we can calculate the work done. That is what the question was asking us. So work is equal to force into displacement. Now we have the force, and we have also been given the displacement in the question, which was 10 meters. So we can easily multiply this and get the work done as 1960 joules. Again, we have to put this negative sign because the force done was negative. The negative sign appears because the direction of the force is opposite to the direction of displacement, so that the work done is negative. Let us now see the second example. Praveen has applied a force of 100 Newton on an object. So now they have already given us the force. But there is an additional thing, that is, he has applied a force at an angle of 60 degrees. So this is theta. So the angle of 60 degrees to the horizontal. The object gets displaced in the horizontal direction and 400 joule of work is done. So here they have also given us the work done. We have to find out what is the displacement of the object. And they have given us cos 60 degrees is half, that is 0.5. So now, what is telling us that this is the object and it is moving in a certain horizontal direction, but the force that is applied to it is at an angle of 60 degrees. Okay, and they have told us the work done and they have also told us what is the force applied. So we have to only find out the displacement. We know that work is equal to force into displacement into cos theta, and they have given us all of these in the example except for the displacement. So we substitute everything. The work was 400 joules, force was 100 newton, displacement is what we have to find out, and cos 60 is half. When you rearrange this formula, we would get the answer of displacement as 8 meters. So now we know that when Praveen put 100 Newton of force at an angle of 60 to an object, the object did a work of 400 joule and the displacement that the object took was 8 meters. Therefore, the object will be displaced through 8 meters.
For the answers to this exercise and other free worksheets, please go to jkacademypro.com.